attention to defend the exceptional waters of the Poconos, which are under threat. The campaign is being rolled out through a series of ads, billboards, and on social media, and through outreach and awareness building. We also have a petition drive to expand our diverse coalition. Through our petition, we want to make sure that decision makers in the region, elected officials, voters, and economic development interests in particular, understand that the water quality of local water needs to remain exceptional. Pollution, and indeed any diminishment of these streams, is neither acceptable nor warranted by relaxation of the rules that protect them.
Even before climate change acknowledgments, scientists and conservationists understood that floodplains, by definition, flood, and that a stream needs ample room, respect, and space to carry and dissipate floodwaters by preserving its natural floodplains. The developers and elected leaders often did not heed these warnings. As a result of this bad planning and overdevelopment, I saw people's homes flooded the second time in 2 weeks in parts of the state, shopping center owners shoring up the doors and foundations of establishments to attempt to keep the waters from entering their places of business, and a cargo train derail and dump over 4,000 gallons of diesel fuel into the Delaware River. This was because of extreme river flows that undermined a culvert where the train was passing over. The good news, though, for the region of the Poconos and why we're all here today, and this beautiful area that still consists of largely forested watersheds and rural charm, is that this story does not have to be the story of the Poconos and the Upper Delaware River. This region of the Poconos has a long tradition of stewardship by the local community and better investment in planning and monitoring of local streams by community volunteers and watershed groups, which has helped keep this area resilient and preserved to better face the changing climates.
Today, however, as I stand on the banks of the Paradise Creek, not only my home, but home to some of the best fly fishing in eastern United States, I find myself fighting for the right for clean water in this stream. Not just for the angler in me, but for the fish that call the Paradise home as well. You can take a stock trout and you can put it in a mud puddle and it will survive for a time. But a wild trout, a native Pennsylvanian trout, requires only the most pristine oxygenated cold water to maintain their food chain and reproduce generation after generation for all of us to enjoy.